Hi everyone. Boy, I still have trouble with the opening. Alfred here from Alfred.tv, and it's November 26, 2014. It's the day before Thanksgiving, and it's nice and early in the morning. And you know what I'm going to do? I'm going to unbox something. But this is part of a bigger unboxing picture here. All right. The goal is to unbox the Xbox One Launch Edition, which I bought a year ago. Well, at launch. Really, it's still in the box. Let me show you. There it is, very, very comfortable, next to the piss foreign machine, okay? But before I open up that, I need to set up a new high-speed wireless, you think I'm gonna edit that out? I say nay, nay, wireless network. And also, I need to really clean up the cable mismanagement system in my beachside condo. Let me show you the current cable mismanagement system. There it is. Is that great? Come on, really. I'd like all my fine viewers to share pictures of their cable mismanagement system. And where does this freaking cable go? It's always good to have a hundred foot Ethernet cable. Oh wait, we got to stop to show the LeBron 12s. Yeah, the new LeBron 12s. Are these amazing? Yeah, really. All right, so we go there, and yeah, it's tethering the FF class Mac Pro double hex, which is still on the dining room table, the one that the mighty, mighty Adam B. and I set up for Holiday Hardware Hacking 2013. Okay, and obviously, by having a Mac Pro on my dining room table, it tells you what? It tells you that I eat out a lot. Okay, anyway, on to the unboxing. So there it is, a 3 terabyte AirPort time capsule. And we're gonna this thing is freaking big, or tall. Yeah, so it is indeed in the box, and the box is tall. Look at this fine, I gotta put the camera down, because I can't do this with one hand. All right, so we'll be back, whatever. Okay, so here you go, geek porn at its finest, and we go like Windows 3.1, ta-da, and yeah, there it is. Yeah, this thing is it's a nice heavy piece of gear, and here it is coming out of the box, which makes sense because I did buy it and I did open the box. So I don't understand why people really watch these unboxing videos. They're kind of stupid, but whatever. Very nice. Get two of them, they make like lovely bookends. And I'm asking myself, where the hell do you plug stuff in? But there's like an ancillary condom on this thing. And by pulling off the ancillary condom, you reveal the ports. Okay, I'm trying not to make this thing go kersmash on the floor. Yeah, so condom removal in progress. One-handed, yeah, one hand, there you go. One-handed condom removal in progress, folks. Again, geek porn with this unboxing shenanigans and pretty much useless video just to hear my crappy jokes. And on the back of the Apple time capsule, we have like a bunch of ports and yeah. So you plug stuff in and you turn it on and you configure it with your Mac and that's it. Done. With an Alfred.tv slow pan shot of the residual of the unboxing, one thing that's missing, Miss Ang, she was an Asian girl I knew, really, her last name was Ang, and I used to call her Miss Ang, and she used to say, don't call me Miss Ang, it sounds like I'm missing. Anyway, one thing that's Miss Ang is that there's no freaking Ethernet cable provided. So if you buy this expensive POS, and I don't mean point of sale, make sure you buy an Ethernet cable. But I happen to have one just kind of laying around on the floor at my cable mismanagement system, so I'm okay. And the bottom line is that you need an Ethernet cable to plug into this bottom Ethernet port, which is the WAN port for wide access network, all right? And that's where you would plug in your DSL, your digit shittle subscriber line, or your cable scrotum, all right, to feed this thing with internet connectivity. Yeah, there you go. That's about as vulgar as I could get. So when I plugged in the time capsule and I heard this really jarring noise from the hard drive because it hasn't been turned on and it's been rotting in the box probably for about 6 months, this art piece started glowing. So the high radiation output from the multiple antennae stimulated the LED array in this art piece. Really? I'm lying. And speaking seriously for a very brief moment, we see that we have an amber status light, which means that this thing can't establish connectivity with the internet or something like that. There's definitely a problem. Okay, so flashing amber. Now, amber is my friend's wife's name, so flashing amber would also mean getting nude in front of my friend's. I did the Elmer Fudd thing, my friend's wife. Yeah, so I guess we'll go to the AirPort Scrutility on the Mac Pro and see if we can talk to this thing and see what's up with flashing amber. Well, I do have to say that this is very convenient because I went over to the Mac Pro and let me show you by pointing the camera at the screen, because I really don't use ScreenFlow, what's waiting for me on my Mac Pro screen. And it's the AirPort Time Capsule Apple Utility Program is like running all by itself because the Mac Pro is currently tethered to my network. So it wants to know the name of the network, base station name, and some passwords. And of course, this is an extremely critical part of the setup, which is specifically what I'm going to name this network. And I know you all want to know what I'm going to name this network. Let me think about it a minute. And whilst I will be calling this base station Beach Capsule, the name of the network will be Piss Off. Which I think is appropriate and nice and not too vulgar. Okay, and after a few gyrations, I get the status screen that Piss Off is now available. Gee, it was almost too easy, which is actually a good thing, I guess. And finally, we do see that the Beach Capsule is indeed connected with the internet with a nice green status light. I assume there's a green status light on the physical device. Let's do a visual inspection. And there we go. It is indeed clean and green. Clean and green. Which is like an old phrase we used to use on the CB radio describing the status of the freeway. But we would say that when there was a major 20-mile traffic jam just to confuse people. Whatever. Oh, wow. So I can remove, like, an Ethernet cable from the cable mismanagement system and back of the Mac Pro. Let's take a look. Oh, yeah. The removal of one cable is really going to make a real big improvement. By the way, that's a wireless Bluetooth speaker. It sounds like shit, but it really looks cool. Actually, back in the bedroom, yes, a relatively significant improvement in cable mismanagement. And the official review of the new Apple Time Capsule. It was in the box. It's tall. And it provides wireless. And you know what? If the throughput from this new device sucks when it's going to the Xbox One, or Xbox One, as we call it, I still have this really long Ethernet cable that I'll just hardwire the freaking thing for maximum throughput. And what happens with maximum throughput on an Xbox One when I'm playing Halo? People will still snipe me and teabag me anyway, which really pisses me off. And a shout out to the Halo crew. You know who you are. More to come. Stay tuned. I wrapped it too tight. I can't get the freaking cable off my arm.
Welcome to Alfred.TV.